Hello friends, welcome to my channel Chemistry with SK. Here in this session, we'll see the concept of cathodic protection. Actually, this concept is useful for corrosion prevention. So, what is the principle behind this technique, cathodic protection? So, we'll see the principle. The principle of this technique is the metal to be protected from corrosion. जिस मेटल को बचाना है करोजन से, the metal to be protected from corrosion is forcefully behaved to act as cathode. It means if naturally corrosion is taking place, it means that metal is acting as anode. If that metal is acting as anode, we have to make it act as cathode. Forcefully we have to do something so that that metal will act as cathode. So this is the principle of the cathodic protection technique. It can be given by two ways. One is sacrificial anode method. Sacrificial anode method and other is impress current method. So we'll see what is sacrificial anode method first. Sacrificial anode method. The name itself implies sacrificial anode. It means the here in this case the upper place metals in the galvanic series like magnesium, zinc, aluminium, these are to be connected with the metal to be protected. For example, let us consider this is a ground surface and we have to protect a pipeline. Suppose this is a pipeline and this pipeline we have to protect from the corrosion. So in this case, what we have to do? The metal to be protected is connected with some highly placed or upper placed metals in the galvanic series and that are placed in the backfill for better electrical contact. So these are highly active metals, highly reactive metals. It may be zinc or magnesium or aluminium, such type of metals, while this is the backfill. Backfill is just for better electrical contact, which is made up of sodium chloride, coal, etc. Mainly you might have observed when in the farm or when we are in the some areas, we need to give some earthings for electrical contact. So that type of earthing can be considered here. So that type of backfill we have to add, backfill. It means when there is a highly reactive metal like zinc or magnesium that is connected here and this pipeline initially it was getting corroded, it was getting disrupted. So now we have connected some higher place, upper place metal in the galvanic series. It is connected with some insulation or insulated wire and then now what will happen? This metal will act as cathode. Because this metal is highly reactive and this metal will act as anode. So this is nothing but sacrificial anode method. This anode is doing sacrifice. It means as in the movie we see the somebody is doing sacrifice as at the end of movie we can say. So similarly this metal is doing sacrifice, this anode is doing sacrifice and that's why it is called as sacrificial anode method. So what will happen after some days or after a few months, this whole metal, zinc or magnesium metal will undergo complete destruction. And if there is a complete destruction of the metal, then we have to add another metal piece, another fresh metal piece is to be connected here for the same purpose. This concept can be useful for corrosion prevention of especially ships. Or ship hulls we can say. Especially for ships, the zinc like metals or zinc or magnesium like metals are bolted at the outer edge of ship, generally which is in the water, which is in the sea water. So we'll see the applications. Mainly this concept is useful in the corrosion of, we can say, water coolers. Water coolers, we can say ship hulls, then buried cables and buried steel pipelines. So these are some of the applications of this method. It can be useful in the protection of corrosion of water coolers, ship hulls, buried cables and buried steel pipelines. So it is about the sacrificial anode method. Now this is the first method, that is sacrificial anode method for the corrosion prevention by using cathodic protection. This is another method, that is, we'll see impressed current method. We'll see what is here in this concept. The impressed current, it means the current is to be passed, the current is to be impressed in opposite direction of the corrosion current. Means what? Suppose we are considering this as a ground surface, as seen in previous case. Suppose it is a ground surface. We have to protect a pipeline. Suppose this is a pipeline to be protected from corrosion. Now, in previous case, we have connected the highly placed or upper placed elements or the metals like zinc and magnesium from the galvanic series by using sacrificial anode method. But this time, we have to pass electric current. We have to impress the current. So, we have to use a battery in which negative terminal of a DC battery is connected to the pipeline to be protected. And to the positive terminal, we have to attach scrap iron or stainless steel or graphite. Suppose this is graphite electrode now, and this is in the backfill. This time the backfill is consisting of gypsum or coke bridge backfill. This is graphite rod and the metal to be protected from corrosion. So in this case, what will happen? If naturally corrosion is taking place without connecting this, before connecting this, it means this metal would be acting as anode. Because its corrosion is taking place, it means it is acting as anode. But we have to connect this metal to the battery, to the negative terminal, and then we have to connect another terminal to the graphite or scrap iron, and we have to impress the current in opposite direction of the corrosion current. What is meant by opposite direction of the corrosion current? It means if previously corrosion is taking place, it means anodic reactions are taking place. So from anode to cathode, there will be transfer of electrons. On anode, what will happen? There will be loss of electron from anode. There will be gain of electron at cathode. It means electrons will be transferred from anode to cathode. And during this process, if there is a transfer of electron, it means there will be flow of electric current in opposite direction. Now, if there is a flow in opposite direction, it means that current is being flown and that current is said to be corrosion current. So, if corrosion is taking place, that is called as corrosion current. So, we have to apply the current from the battery with the help of this DC battery in opposite direction of the corrosion current, so that this corrosion current will be nullified and no corrosion will take place. This is the main concept behind this. So, it is all about the impressed current method. We'll see the applications. So, what are the applications of this? We'll see the applications of this technique, that is impressed current method. It is useful for corrosion prevention of mainly lead up ships. There are the ships which are lead up at the coast, we can say, at coastal area. Then buried steel pipelines, steel pipelines. Water tanks, etc. So these are the applications of this technique, impressed current method.